Hello and welcome back to another video. My name is Mike Davies and today I'll be showing you how to download and install the Resynthesizer plugin for GIMP. I'll be using GIMP version 2.10.30, which is the latest version of GIMP at the time of this tutorial. Before I get into that, guys, don't forget to check out my website at daviesmediadesign.com. You can enroll in my GIMP 2.10 Masterclass from beginner to pro photo editing on Udemy, and you can get more by becoming a DMD premium member, and I'll include a link to this as well as all the relevant links from this tutorial in the description of the video. So this tutorial is actually a remake of a tutorial I did back in 2019. The reason I'm remaking it is that some things for the Resynthesizer plugin have been moved around, so they are in new locations. But for those of you who are not familiar with this plugin, the Resynthesizer plugin allows you to perform a few different photo manipulation effects. The most famous one for this plugin is going to be the heel selection feature, and that's basically the equivalent to Photoshop's content aware fill. And what that's going to do is allow you to intelligently fill in a selection area to erase an object. You can also use the heel transparency feature, which allows you to intelligently heal in transparent areas anywhere on your image, but most notably around the borders of the image. For example, when you want to increase the size or bring out the boundary of your image. And finally, you can naturally blend patterns so that they don't look super choppy and digital, they just look more natural. I do have separate tutorials on these features. I will be doing a quick demo for this tutorial after we install the plugin, but let's dive into installing the plugin. So here is the Resynthesizer plugin on GitHub. I will include a link to this in the description of the video. So you're gonna wanna scroll down and come over here to the readme.md file, MD standing for markdown. And we're just gonna click on this file. And this will always give you information as to where you can download this plugin, but the information does tend to change as it has in the last few years. So here you'll see a section called installation. If you're gonna use this for Linux, go ahead and click the Linux option. We're gonna be using Windows for this tutorial, so I'll go with the Windows option there. And here you'll see the Windows option is just going to say an archive of the Resynthesizer plugin for Windows. So this has changed since the last time I did this video. Click on this link here, and now you'll see the Resynthesizer zip file. This is going to be the file we wanna download. So all you have to do is come over here to this button that says download. Click that button. And I'm gonna download this to my downloads folder. I've already downloaded this before, so it's giving me a 1 here, but I'll just come over here and click save. So once your file has finished downloading, you'll see the zip file here. You're gonna click this little arrow and go to show in folder. So there it is in our downloads folder. The first thing you wanna do is extract all the files from this. So right click and go to extract all. And you can choose the destination where you want to extract these files. If you know where the GIMP plugin file is right now, you can extract it directly to there. But I will show you how to get into the GIMP plugin folder. So let's just hit extract. And it will open up once it's finished extracting. So let's double click to enter this folder. And now you can see all the files from the plugin. And the last tutorial, I included the Lisez-moi file into the actual plugins folder for GIMP. I was informed that Lisez-moi, of course, is just readme in French. I should know that I took a year and a half of French in college. But you're gonna see several script files here. These are gonna be the actual plugin features, and then another readme file in English, and then a couple of application files here. So we're gonna leave this here for now. The next step is we're gonna open up GIMP. So I already have GIMP open here on my computer, and we're going to locate the plugins folder. So we'll go to Edit, Preferences, and we're gonna scroll down using the scroll bar here to where it says folders, and we're going to expand that and scroll down some more. So here you'll see our plugins folder. I'll click on that. You're gonna wanna go with the plugins folder that says appdata/roaming in it. So click on that. That is going to be the file that GIMP wants you to use, the folder GIMP wants you to use to put in user installed plugins. So next what I'll do is come over here and you're gonna see a little filing cabinet icon. Click on that. And that's gonna open up a file explorer with the plugins folder highlighted. So double click to enter that folder. I've already got a couple of plugins here. You guys might have an empty folder. But next we're gonna open up the file explorer that contained the extracted Resynthesizer files. And a quick note, not all of these work in GIMP 2.10.30. I'm gonna try to exclude the ones that don't. But what I'll do is hold the control key and click on the plugin heel selection. Hill transparency, map style does not work. Render texture, I believe, still works. Actually, I'm not 100% on that, but we're gonna just go ahead and install it anyway. And fill pattern definitely works, sharpen works, and plugin uncrop does not work. So we're going to control click on the last two application files here. So the Resynthesizer and Resynthesizer GUI. If you're feeling lazy, you can just drag all of these into here. But now I'm just going to drag and drop these into the plugins folder. So I'll release my mouse. So there we have our plugin files installed. And now we can exit out of the File Explorer windows here. We're going to just exit out of the preferences window. You are going to have to exit out of GIMP. So I'll just click the red X there in the corner. And now let me just reopen up GIMP. All right, so we have GIMP reopened here. Now what I can do is open up that test composition I was doing. So I'll go to File, Open Recent, and go with this file here. So the actual plugin files are gonna be in a couple of different menus, but I'm going to demonstrate the Hill Selection option. So the Hill Selection is gonna be found by going to Filters, Enhance, and here you'll see it, Hill Selection. Hill transparency is right below it, but it's grayed out right now because I don't have any transparency on this image. So let's demonstrate the Hill Selection option. I have my Free Select tool selected here. So what I'll do is just select the object I want to erase, hit the Enter key, and go to Filters, Enhance, Hill Selection. So now we're going to get this Python foo dialog window, and it says Hill Selection. So context sampling width is the amount of pixels you want to pull from around the image. I'll go with 100 for this. Sample from is the area where you're pulling the pixels. So in this case, we can go all around the selection, but you can choose sides or above and below if you want to restrict it to those areas. And then the filling order will just stick with random, but you can start from the outside here and go inwards or start from the inside and go outwards. But we're going to go with random here, and I'll click OK. All right, and there you can see it has erased that object. So I'll hit Control-Shift-A to deselect that. It's done a really good job. It did copy this little speck over here. You can always hit the H key to grab the Hill tool. Decrease the size of the brush. Control-click to select an area, and then bam, get rid of that. Hold Control-click, get rid of that. And now it looks like she's staring into the sun or something and worshiping some object in the sky. All right, so that's it for this tutorial. Hopefully you liked it. If you did, don't forget to like this video, subscribe to my channel, and click the bell icon to be notified each time I have a brand new tutorial. You can check out any of the links to my resources in the description of the video. But thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.